Hi, we're the Joyful Johnsons. One day we woke up and decided it was time for a change. So we sold everything that we owned, packed up a few suitcases, hopped on an airplane with three toddlers, two dogs too, and flew to beautiful Costa Rica. Are we crazy? Probably. But together, we are discovering what a beautiful adventure life can really be.
Today we're going to be going to the Barra National Park to explore some caverns. We are super excited, although extremely nervous. Of the 42 caverns that are known at Barra, there are 19 of them that have been explored. You can set reservations and they will provide all gear if you don't have any gear. It's about $30 per person. They say that there's kid accessibility as well at about $17 a person, but we don't know what type of age range we're talking about. Plan for about 3 to 4 hours of your day for the hike, the cavern exploring, and then to go back. You definitely need a tour guide to be able to do this as well. So we're here at the park and we signed in, made the first payment. You have to make a payment for the entrance of the park and then you have to make a second payment for the caverns and the gear. We actually had to drive 2 kilometers uphill. And actually there's 2 stopping points. There's 1 at 1 kilometer, 1 at a 2nd kilometer. If you have a 4-wheel drive vehicle, then you can get to the second parking lot. But if not, you have to stop at the first parking lot and walk the rest of the way. It is a total of 4 kilometers, 2 kilometers drive with a 4-wheel drive vehicle, and then 2 more kilometers walk. So we're about to walk the rest of the way and, hopefully make it soon. It's normally really hot in Costa Rica. And even this morning back in Playa Junquial, it was really hot. But right now we're in pants, boots, and it actually feels really comfortable. We only drove for maybe about an hour. So considering the circumstances, it's really, really comfortable right now.
Where are you going, Justin?
I'm going on an adventure.
We're about to go down our descent. It's 16 meters down, and they make you wear a mask, not just because of COVID, but actually the bat fungus, and so there's a smell, and they're trying to help prevent you from getting diseases.
This is our holy family. We go. It's a natural formation, and when the people start exploring, discover the core, compared with the lovers, or look like a car, it's a natural formation, and the jellyfish. And then that we have the bats. This is a limestone, every formation, Barahonda. Everything from the seabed. Is the reason we have a lot of limestone here. Yes, when the process started forming, so normally the limestone made like a break. We call that process the cast. It's a break in the stone. Then the rainwater coming in, it starts to dissolve the calcium carbonate. You know, the rainwater has acid carbonic. It starts to form in the hole.
This is the ladder to leave. It looks like it's about 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 full 10-foot ladders tied together. They were secured really, really well, though. The drop. Wow. Just wow. And here's our frog. He's hanging out for some water. So we just finished going down Cavern Terciopelo. It was good. I enjoyed it a lot. I'm sweaty. If you don't like ladders at all, this is not the place for you. It's at least 50 steps on the ladder alone. But I enjoyed it. There were no small spaces you had to crawl through. You just had to be not afraid to go up and down a giant ladder and be very careful with your footing. I'd recommend it though. If you're in the area and you want something different to do, you won't find this in the Cave of Winds down in Colorado. It's completely different. So, I recommend it.